I said, when Mr. Van, the man running for Attorney General, shows up in your neck of the woods, you're going to ask him, what economists have influenced your view of free market economics, and what books do you recommend to your constituents and colleagues to better understand free market economics? Or better yet, send him a Facebook message with that question. And guess what? All my Yale friends in North Carolina jumped at the challenge. And pretty soon, Dan Forrest, who's now Lieutenant Governor of North Carolina, changed his stump speech, and he started talking about how he uses the book, Whatever Happened to Penny Candy, with his kids whom he's homeschooling to teach them free market economics. And Whatever Happened to Penny Candy is an excellent book on free market economics. So you can make a difference. You can force them to talk about things they ought to be talking about. So show up, but learn how to be effective. Remember, it's the number and effectiveness that matters. So it's not just showing up, knowing what to do and how to do it to get there. Take a page from PIRG, the Public Interest Research Group, Ralph Nader's left-wing organization, and use petitions to educate the public. Ralph Nader started this in the 70s. He would put together these pages that looked like a petition, but they weren't going to any elected official. He was just using them to propagandize people. He would say in the petition, isn't it a pity that the Mississippi River is so polluted and shouldn't we do more to preserve water quality in the United States? And he'd have his young college students go around throughout suburban areas and everywhere just saying, would you sign this petition? And it was a way to imply that water was getting dirtier and that more water regulations were needed. And guess what else it did? It collected names and addresses or emails from people whom they could later involve in campaigns or hit them up for money or whatever. So you got an issue you want to take to the public. An easy way to take it to the public is face-to-face. Do a petition. Go to the local county fair. Go to some place there are going to be a lot of people and say, would you mind reading this petition and signing it? You got to keep it short, but you can use it as an education tool. Organize a ghostwriting campaign. Letters to the editor. Online publications as well. Organize a letter. A lot of people are willing to sign a letter, but they don't have time to write one. So if you could write letters for people and then get them to people at the Tea Party or wherever, they'll send them to the papers. And remember, in Arkansas, as in most states, your big city papers won't print many of your letters. But small town papers will. They'll print a verbatim. And if you get letters written, do a ghostwriting campaign, and get letters out to small towns across Arkansas and have local people submit them to the local yokel newspaper, especially the weeklies and the semi-weeklies, they'll print these letters verbatim, and it is a cheap and easy education tool for the public. Set up a table at a public event, like you're tabling on campus, but make your table effective. If you've never done the Youth Leadership School at the Leadership Institute, bring one to your campus, they'll teach you how to table. Yale will give you tips for tabling too, but don't just use it tabling as a way of building up your Yale chapter. Use it as a way of meeting the public. Take your petition drive to a table or a booth at the local fair, wherever. Anytime you have a chance to interact with the public, remember person-to-person, one-on-one conversations are always the strongest political communications. Volunteer in a campaign, even if the candidate is not 100% perfect. No candidate is 100% perfect. Get involved early in the primary season so you don't have the lesser of two evil problem in the fall and November. Get involved when it makes a difference. And if you will get involved in the primary campaigns and get some skills, maybe some people who come closer to 100% perfection will run for office. Because one reason they don't is they don't think you'll step up to the plate and support them. So start doing it. your own campaign boot camp at your school, in your community. Demonstrate to the people of your community that the UCA Young Americans for Liberty chapter is not the future leaders of Arkansas, but are the current leaders, the present leaders of politics in Arkansas. Organize a boot camp here, and then recruit the local, the regional Tea Parties to come and take part in it. The local party organizations, tell them we're doing a boot camp, campaign boot camp at UCA, and we'd like to invite you to participate. It'll be on Saturday, the whatever of April, and we're going to have it at such and such a place. Come in, and we're going to train people how to be more effective activists. Step up to the plate now and show the people of this state that you are the present leaders, not the future leaders. Going to have to organize a campaign boot camp. Send me a message on Revolutionary Communications. We'll have Leadership Institute out here doing a boot camp for you. Show a positive face to the community with a well-chosen service project. We know what we are against in terms of government interventions in our society, but we don't often put a positive face on what we stand for. Voluntary, charitable, human-driven institutions, not government-driven institutions. So get involved in a clothing drive. Get a couple of your buddies to help you share a soccer team and coach a soccer team in the local soccer league or little league baseball. Do some tutoring at a local school. Let people know who you are and what you stand for and that you believe in voluntary actions, not coercive government programs. Raise money for a cause or a candidate. And especially in a primary, when you raise money early, $100 or $200 can mean a lot to a primary candidate. So get involved early and raise money for a cause, a charitable